إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. أما بعد أيها الأحبة في الله، إن موضوعنا اليوم موضوع خطير وحساس، فلذلك أرجو من الجميع أن ينتبه وأن يستمع جيداً حتى لا يسيء الفهم. The topic today is a very sensitive one. And so I hope that everyone listens carefully so that you do not misunderstand anything. الموضوع يتعلق بالكفر. So the topic has to do with disbelief and disbelievers. الكفر والكفار. أقول مستعينا بالله سبحانه وتعالى إن أقبح الأمور على الإطلاق أن يبارز الإنسان ربه بالكفر به والصد عن صراطه الذي خلق الخلق من أجله. فلذلك إن الكافر هين على الله سبحانه وتعالى لا يبالي الله بأي واد أهلكه. Let me begin by saying that the most loathsome of things, the filthiest and the ugliest of things that a person can do is to oppose their Lord subhanahu wa ta'ala by disbelieving in him and by standing in the way that he has laid down for the people to follow. Allah has created people for a reason, and that is to follow his path. So the worst of people and the worst of deeds are from those who stand in the way of that path. And this is why Allah subhanahu, or the kafir, meaning the non-Muslim, is worthless in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he could not care less where that person dies. أيها الأخيار، كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم وهو سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين يستعيذ من الكفر، فكان إذا أصبح وإذا أمسى يقول ثلاثا: اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر، وأعوذ بك من عذاب القبر، لا إله إلا أنت. The Messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he was the leader of the prophets. He was the leader of all the messengers. Being who he was, he used to seek refuge with Allah. In other words, he used to seek protection with Allah from al-kufr or disbelief. And he used to say every morning and every evening, three times, the following dua: اللهم إني أعوذ بك من الكفر والفقر وأعوذ بك من عذاب القبر لا إله إلا أنت. The meaning of this dua is, O Allah, I seek refuge with you. In other words, I seek your protection from disbelief and poverty. And I seek refuge with you. That is, I seek your protection from the punishment of the grave. There is none worthy of worship but you. وكان حبيبنا صلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وهو الذي عصم الله قلبه من الزيغ وعصم الله عقله من الهوى وعصم الله لسانه من الباطل واللغو والفحش ومع ذلك يستعيذ من الكفر فأحرى بنا أيها المسلمون وأجدر أن نستعيذ بالله من الكفر إذا أصبحنا وإذا أمسينا. Our beloved, that is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, used to seek Allah's protection from disbelief, from kufr, from following a way other than the way of al-Islam. And who was he? He was that individual whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected in every way. He protected his heart from misguidance. He protected his tongue from uttering that which is useless. He protected his tongue from uttering that which is filthy. And yet he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to seek refuge with Allah from disbelief. This should tell us that we, or it is more befitting that you and I on a regular basis seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from disbelief. طيب هذا الكفر الذي أتحدث عنه ما هو ما حقيقة الكفر؟ أقول الكفر هو ضد الإيمان يعني ضد الإسلام وذلك لأنه جحود الحق وإنكاره جحود الحق وإنكاره والكافر إذن ضد المسلم والمرتد الكافر هو ضد المسلم والمرتد أيضا كافر إلا أنه هو الذي كفر بعد إسلامه يعني دخل في الإسلام ثم كفر بشيء من أفعاله أو اعتقاداته أو شكوكه وما إلى ذلك. So this kufr or disbelief that I'm speaking of, what is it and what is the nature of kufr or disbelief? When we talk about al-kufr or disbelief, of course it is the opposite of belief. In other words, the opposite of Islam. Because the reality of it is a denial and rejection of the truth, which is al-Islam. And when we speak of the kafir or the disbeliever, then the disbeliever is the opposite of the Muslim. And the murtad or the apostate is a disbeliever, except that this is an individual who entered Islam and then left Islam afterwards through some of their actions or false beliefs and so on and so forth. إن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أمرنا أن نكره الكفر وأن نمقت الأسباب المؤدية إليه يعني إلى الكفر. So the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم ordered and commanded us to detest, to hate disbelief, and to also hate all of that which leads to disbelief. قال الله سبحانه وتعالى لا تجد قوما يؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر يوادون من حاد الله ورسوله ولو كانوا آباءهم أو أبناءهم أو إخوانهم أو عشيرتهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what means. You will never find a people who truly believe in Allah and the last day loyal to or having affection for those who defy and oppose Allah and His Messenger, even if they were their parents, their children, their siblings, or their clan. In other words, their extended family. وقال الله سبحانه وتعالى قد كانت لكم أسوة حسنة في إبراهيم والذين معه إذ قالوا لقومهم إنا براء منكم ومما تعبدون من دون الله كفرنا بكم وبدا بيننا وبينكم العداوة والبغضاء أبدا حتى تؤمنوا بالله وحده. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also says what means, you have an excellent example already in Ibrahim and those who were with him, when they said to their people, we totally disassociate ourselves from you and shun whatever idols you worship besides Allah. We reject you. We deny you. The enmity and hatred that has arisen between us and you will last until you believe in Allah alone. I hope that we're listening carefully, because here I am not presenting to you any of my opinions. I am relating to you what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran. So those who do not like the words hate, and those who do not like the words enmity, take it up with Allah, don't take it up with me. These are the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَمَرَنَا رَسُولُنَا صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ أَن نَكْرَهَ الْكُفْرَ وَالْأَسْبَابَ الْمُؤَدِّيَةَ إِلَى الْكُفْرِ. ثبت في الصحيحين من حديث أنس رضي الله عنه وأرضاه أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال: ثلاث من كن فيه وجد بهن حلاوة الإيمان: أن يكون الله ورسوله أحب إليه مما سواهما، وأن يكره أن يعود في الكفر بعد إذ أنقذه الله منه، كما يكره أن يقذف في النار، وأن يحب المرأة لا يحبه إلا لله. And it is found in an authentic hadith in both Sahih al-Bukhari and Sahih Muslim from the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu warḍah that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, there are three qualities which if they are found in an individual, that individual will experience the beauty of faith. That individual will taste the sweetness of faith. Those three qualities are that Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam be dear to that person. They are more beloved to that person than anyone or anything else. And for an individual to love another solely for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for a person to hate, to fall into disbelief, just as he would hate or she would hate to be thrown into a fire. إذن أحبتي في الله الواجب على المسلم أن يكره الكفر وأن يبتعد عن الأسباب المؤدية إليه وأن يعلم أن كلمة الكافر تشمل الكافر الأصلي كاليهود والنصارى والمجوس والذين أشركوا والملاحدة والدهريين ومن يعبدون البقر ومن يعبدون الشمس أو القمر أو الوثن أو الحجر كل هؤلاء داخلون تحت هذا الاسم البغيض بئس الاسم الفسوق بعد الإيمان وتشمل كذلك من كان كافرا كفر ردة وقلنا المرتد هو من كان مسلما ثم ترك الإسلام. So it is mandatory for the Muslim to hate disbelief, to detest and to reject disbelief, and to stay away from everything that could lead them to disbelief. And we need to understand again this word that is used very often by the Muslims, al-kafir. And as an aside, we have so-called Muslims today who say, don't use that word, it's offensive. It's offensive. Once again, take it up with Allah. I didn't invent the word. I'm not the one who presented it over and over in the Quran. It is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You have a problem with the word kafir, you have a problem with Islam. You have a problem with Islam, you have a problem with Allah. So beware of that. When we speak of the kafir, then what you have to understand is this term kafir encompasses people who are kuffar asliyin. By that we mean, I mean, what's a good way of putting it? Original disbelievers, people such as the Christians and the Jews. The Christians and the Jews and the Magians and those who worship the cow, those who worship idols, those who call themselves atheists or secularists, all of these people are kuffar, kafirin. One of them is a kafir, a disbeliever, one who rejects the truth, one who rejects al-Islam, one who opposes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of these people fall under the category of al-kafir. And the kafir also includes the apostate. Once again, the apostate is that individual who was a Muslim, and then through a certain action or through certain false beliefs and so forth, that person left the fold of Islam. أيها المسلمون كما أن ديننا أمرنا أن نكره الكفار فكذلك جلى لنا فعالهم القبيحة وأوصافهم الدنيئة لنحذرها ونحذر منها. وسنذكر الآن بإيجاز شديد بعض تلك الصفات. Yes, Islam, that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who legislated Islam for us, has ordered us and commanded us to hate, to reject, and to detest the disbelievers. And here, let me just pause for a second. If I hate broccoli, does it mean that I'm going to smash it all up and not allow anybody to eat it? Let's be intelligent for a while. And this is especially for the wicked media. And this is especially for the enemies of Islam who like to take the words of the Muslims out of context and who try to define for us what we are saying. When I say I hate something or someone, let's say that I hate someone, it means I hate them because of something that they stand for example. But it does not in any way, shape, or form indicate violence. Hatred is not equivalent to violence. Hatred might lead to violence, but not necessarily. So I'm saying to you that Allah, our Lord, who legislated for us al-Islam as our way of life, has commanded us and ordered us to hate and to detest the disbelievers for the disbelief that they carry. This doesn't necessitate violence. Please understand this, because the feeble-minded amongst the Muslims, those who have no understanding of anything in this religion, will agree with the non-Muslims who want to impose that definition on us. They want us to think that hatred means violence, but it does not. I'm saying that to you in no uncertain terms. Again, this religion of ours has taught us to hate the disbelievers. Clear? I've already qualified this. Remember this at the RCMP and CSIS when you're listening. The qualifier has preceded. To hate the disbelievers. Then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala did not leave that be. In addition to that, Allah jalla wa ala makes clear for us their ugly attributes. The ugly attributes and deeds of the disbelievers, the kuffar. We're going to mention a few of them now. مِن تِلْكَ الْأَوْصَافِ وَمِن تِلْكَ الْأَفْعَالِ مَا يَلِي السُّخْرِيَةُ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْإِيمَانِ وَالْإِسْتِهْزَاءُ بِهِمْ. يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى زُيِّنَ لِلَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا الْحَيَاةُ الدُّنْيَا وَيَسْخَرُونَ مِنَ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَالَّذِينَ اتَّقَوْا فَوْقَهُمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ وَاللَّهُ يَرْزُقُ مَنْ يَشَاءُ بِغَيْرِ حِسَابٍ. The first of those qualities or attributes that I would like to mention is their mocking and their ridiculing of the people of Iman, of the believers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what means. The life of this world has been made appealing to the disbelievers. And they mock and ridicule the believers. But those who are mindful of Allah, in other words, those who fear Allah, will rank above them on the Day of Judgment. And Allah provides for whomever He wills without limit. ويقول الله سبحانه وتعالى عن سخرية الكفار من قوم نوح ويصنع الفلك وكلما مر عليه ملأ من قومه سخروا منه قال إن تسخروا منا فإنا نسخر منكم كما تسخرون. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us about the disbelievers and what they did with the Prophet Nuh alayhi salam and his people. Allah Jalla wa ala tells us what means that Nuh alayhi salam began to build the ark. And whenever some of the chiefs, you know, the high level people from his community passed by, they mocked and ridiculed him. So he said to them, if you laugh at us now, if you are ridiculing us now, then just wait. Soon enough, we will be the ones laughing at you. As we say in English, what do we say? Who has the last laugh? It is we who will have the last laugh. وَمِن صِفَاتِهِمْ كَذَلِكَ الْغُرُورُ وَالِاسْتِكْبَارِ Ya Subhanallah. وَنَحْنُ الْآنَ نَنْظُرُ إِلَى هَذِهِ الصِّفَاتِ وننظر إلى هذه الفعال كما جاءت في كتاب الله سبحانه وتعالى أرجو من الجميع أن ينتبه لواقعنا ألا نجد في الكفار أنهم يستهزئون بنا أنهم يسخرون منا ألا نجد فيهم الغرور والاستكبار بلى هذا نراه بأعيننا كل يوم يقول الله سبحانه وتعالى إن الكافرون إلا في غرور هكذا يصفهم ربنا سبحانه وتعالى ليس يونس هو الذي يصفهم بل هو ربنا سبحانه وتعالى الذي يصفهم and from their attributes or qualities is that they are deluded and they are arrogant and you know as we go through some of these attributes of the disbelievers as found in the Quran, as found in the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, I want you to pay attention because we live among the disbelievers and we deal with them on a daily basis. And the one who has a proper understanding of things will see, certainly this is what we find in them. Do we not see the disbelievers ridiculing and mocking us? They may mock us for the way we dress. They mock us for our beliefs. They ridicule us because we reject the LGBTQ movement. Correct or not? This is what we see. They are also deluded. They think they know everything. They think they are, you know, the head honchos. They are where it's at. They are deluded. And again, this is a quality that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions in the Quran of them when he says what means the disbelievers are only lost in delusion. وَمِن صِفَاتِهِمْ أَيْضًا أَنَّ حَيَاتَهُمْ تُشَابِهُ حَيَاتَ الْأَنْعَامِ فَيُفَرِّطُونَ فِي الشَّهَوَاتِ وَالْمَلَذَّاتِ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى وَالَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا يَتَمَتَّعُونَ وَيَأْكُلُونَ كَمَا تَأْكُلُ الْأَنْعَامُ وَالنَّارُ مَثْوًى لَهُمْ مرة أخرى راقب الناس الملذات والشهوات يعيشون من أجلها فهم كالأنعام بل هم أضلوا سبيلا From their qualities as well is that they live a life of animals. They live like beasts, not like human beings. This Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies for us. And this is why we see them exaggerating, going to extremes in fulfilling their desires and their lusts. Nightclubs, drugs, you name it. We see all of these things in them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us what means. As for the disbelievers, they enjoy themselves and feed like cattle. In other words, they go about, you know, just like animals, doing whatever they wish, eating whatever they want, but the fire will be their home. Again, what this means is that the disbelievers enjoy their lives, enjoy in quotation marks, to the fullest. while they're heedless of what is going to happen to them in the hereafter. Just like the cattle that graze in the pastures are unaware of the fact that they will probably end up in the slaughterhouse. أحبتي في الله كما قلت إن الموضوع خطير وحساس وللحديث بقية ولأننا لا نريد أن نطيل عليكم أقول سنواصل الحديث في الأسبوع المقبل بإذن الله تبارك وتعالى أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. As I said at the beginning, it's a very sensitive and dangerous topic, and there's a lot more to be said. And just so that we don't make it too long, I'm going to stop here with this topic for today, and we will continue next week, insha'Allah ta'ala. ولكن قبل أن أفارقكم في هذا اليوم, كما يعلم الجميع, فإني قد كنت مسافرا, وقد سافرت إلى بلد من بلاد المسلمين. وبعد العودة أود أن أقول لكم استبشروا بالخير فإن محمدا خلف رجالا فإن محمدا صلى الله عليه وسلم خلف رجالا استبشروا بالخير فإن في الأمة خير أما حكامنا فحدثوا ولا حرج أما الشعوب ففيها الخير العظيم وهذا قد رأيته بأم عيني دائما نتحدث عن مأساة الأمة ولا شك هناك بلاوي في الأمة هناك مأساة إلا أن الشعوب فيها خير عظيم الذي دائما نخاف منه أن الناس لا يصلون ولكني استبشرت خيرا حينما كنت أتجول في تلك البلاد ورأيت الناس يصلون في المساجد المساجد عامرة ولله الحمد ورأيت الناس يصلون في الشوارع يعني الذي فاتته الصلاة في المسجد لا يترك الصلاة وإنما يصلي في الشارع بجانب خيوله أو مصلحته المهم أنه يصلي هذا ما رأيته أنا فأحببت أن أشارككم هذا الفرح استبشروا بالخير والآن نتحدث عن الكفر حتى نحذر منه حتى نحذر منه اعلموا علم اليقين أن الكفار يعملون كل ما في وسعهم ليخرجونا عن ديننا ولكنهم قد فشلوا ولن ينجحوا أبدا. Before I part company with you this afternoon, as all of you are aware, I was away, I was traveling, and I happened to travel to a Muslim country. And I want to say to you after my return, receive glad tidings. We have reason to be happy, and we have reason to have great hope. What am I saying? I'm saying that we speak very often of ourselves, the Muslim community, and how horrible things are. And what calamities have befallen us. And it is true, we have a lot of problems. We are not perfect by any means. We have many problems within us. As a global Muslim community, we have major problems among us. However, we should never forget the good that exists amongst us. So here I am in this Muslim country, and I traveled quite a bit across the country. And I noticed that this ummah has so much good in it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam left behind real men, so fear not. There are real men in this ummah. Know that Islam is strong and alive. No matter how much the non-Muslims try to avert us, no matter how much they strive to take us away from Islam, except that they have failed and they will never ever succeed. The masajid, they were full. Subhanallah. We are led to believe that nobody prays anymore. We are led to believe that the masajid are empty. But I saw masajid which were filled. In addition to that, I witnessed myself in all of these different regions that those who did not pray in the masjid, if they missed the salah in the masjid, or they were too busy with their business, I mean, okay, that shouldn't be an excuse, but let's just say that this is the way it is. You know, the man is busy with horse rides for the tourists and so on and so forth, so they missed the salah in the masjid. But guess what? Even though they may have missed the salah in the masjid, they did not let the salah go. I myself saw them in so many areas, praying on the street, the man next to his horse, the woman next to her food cart, and so on and so forth. So I say to you, glad tidings. Feel good about this ummah. Know that good still exists in this ummah, and it will always exist in this ummah. Because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam left behind real men. And I beg of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us of those who adhere to this deen, to make us of those who are proud of our Islam, to make us of those who understand what disbelief is, what the reality of it is, and why we need to beware of it, and to stay away from everything that leads to it. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. Allahumma a'izz al-Islam wal-Muslimin. اللهم انصر من نصر الدين واخذل من خذل الدين اللهم انصر المجاهدين في سبيلك في كل مكان اللهم ثبت أقدامهم واربط على قلوبهم وأنزل السكينة عليهم وانصرهم على عدوهم وعدوك يا عزيز ويا قوي اللهم انصر إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم خذ بأيديهم وعجل بنصرهم يا عزيز ويا قوي يا جبار يا منتقم اللهم أرنا في أعدائك عجائب قدرتك اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر اللهم أرنا فيهم يوما أسودا اللهم أرنا فيهم يوما أسودا اللهم أرنا فيهم يوما أسودا اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم إنا نسألك إيمانا كاملا ويقينا صادقا وعملا صالحا متقبلا اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى اللهم أصلح حال هذه الأمة اللهم أصلح حالنا اللهم أصلح حالنا وردنا إلى دينك ردا جميلا اللهم ألف بين قلوبنا ووحد صفوفنا واجمع كلمتنا على الحق يا رب العالمين اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وآخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين قوموا إلى صلاتكم رحمكم الله